Hello, this module will elaborate on the business economics of building EV concepts as a system. The electric vehicles are not new. Already by the end of the 19th century, electric vehicles were built. In the beginning, electric motors seems very promising than more than combustion engine. Only strong men were able to manually start the primitive auto combustion engines. The advantage of EVs were the excellent drivability and comfort of operation. In 1914, the EV share in the Dutch car fleet was 2.4%, which is still higher than today's. Most of them were 62 French-German Krieger Namach taxis in Amsterdam and Haarlem. Already on his first job, Ferdinand Porsche designed the Loner electric car. A four-wheel drive hybrid version used a petrol generator as a range extender. The last electric vehicle by Porsche was called Le Toujours Content, which means always satisfied in French. What did we need more? Little, till Cadillac introduced the first car with an electric self-starter in 1912. Thanks to this electric motor, the internal combustion engine became the first choice for all. About 100 years later, we may now be at the end of the Ice Age, the end of the internal combustion engine. The new game changer is the decarbonization of by renewable electricity, direct or indirect from the sun. Of course, the modern EV benefits from advanced electronics and battery technology. However, today, the EV has to compete in a huge and very mature market of combustion cars. Cars made in efficient mass production with a perfect running supply chain. They are supported by a huge after-sales network and established refueling infrastructure. How can electric vehicles compete with that? Let's start with the notion that good competitive EVs are not just electrified combustion vehicles. Designing and building optimized, reliable and profitable EVs needs a system approach. Especially the new supply chain and focus on mobility as a service are often underestimated. Moreover, rethinking of the business includes charging and a customer support data network. That's also why existing OEMs are struggling so hard to kickstart with electric vehicles. Since for them, it's a high-risk, disruptive technology, new capital of new business model, and a waste of sunk capital. Let's look at some general product design differences caused by the electric drivetrain. As the energy density of batteries is 50 times lower than fuels, the vehicle will be much heavier. For cars, this is typically 300 to 500 kilograms more. For buses and trucks, it will be 1,000 kilograms more. This leads to a new design rule, which favors the use of more advanced lightweight materials. Expensive composite or aluminium directly pay off by saving battery weight and battery cost. The allowed cost per kilogram weight saving is about 1 euro for an ECE car, but about 10 euro for an EV. The packaging of EVs should respect the laws of gravity and driving stability. For stability, the heavy batteries should be placed as low and distributed as possible. Battery packs can be integrated to be a part of a strong underbody floor structure. On the other hand, compact size and low cost of electric motors is beneficial for the packaging. The size and cost advantage opens the possibility to better distribute the power to all wheels. A nice example is the autonomy skateboard, which General Motors showed already in 2002. Electric motors are flexible and don't need clutches and gears, a flywheel, starter, and dynamo. They are so compact and so powerful that they can even be placed direct drive inside the wheels. In-wheel motors are an ultimate solution to create the most efficient traction and more space. Buses and trucks equipped with e-traction wheels leave more utility space inside the vehicle. The platform design with batteries in the middle floor is now adopted in most modern e-cars. Altogether, the EV package has extra space advantages like a front trunk and flat floor. The low point of gravity concept may also prove to be the best solution for trucks and buses. Styling is of all-time importance. Early electrified cars, like the first Prius, were born quite ugly. Maybe this was to limit the sales, but quote the Fiat 500e, the worst form of pollution is ugliness. Electric vehicles are not only very quick in acceleration, but also fast in top speed. Air resistance is a quadratic function of speed. This is true for every vehicle. So energy need normally should increase consumption relatively strong at higher speed. However, that is not what we always experience driving combustion engine cars. This is because in low gear and idling for city traffic, combustion vehicles are very inefficient. In contrast, electric motors show a very high and relatively constant efficiency at all speeds. At zero speed, the energy consumption is near zero. At 60 kilometers per hour, it's about 5 kilowatt power for a car. However, at 120 kilometers per hour, the electricity power need already has reached well above 20 kilowatt. To get a good high-speed range, excellent aerodynamics is very important for designing EVs. We are used to the fact that the speed of a vehicle equals the power of the combustion engine. There is no substitute for cubic inches. In EVs, the electric motor is often not the most limiting factor, but the capacity of the battery is. There is no substitute for kilowatt hours. The so-called C rate, the battery power divided by the capacity, is an important design criterion. 60 kilowatt hour power drawn or charged in a 30 kilowatt hour capacity battery equals a C rate of 2. While the same 60 kilowatt hour derived from a 90 kilowatt hour battery only equals a C rate of 2/3. A higher C rate is more demanding for the battery and can lower the battery lifetime. So small batteries should deliver and be charged at proportionally less power than big ones. That's why a Tesla S with 60 kilowatt hour is slower than a 100 kilowatt hour version, while having the same motor. Good thermal management is of the battery can, however, reduce the difference in battery life. 10 years and 160,000 kilometer warranty is normal for modern electric cars. However, practice shows that well-conditioned battery packs can even last longer. The first series Tesla taxis at Schiphol Airport lost only 6% battery range after 300,000 kilometers. And the 2011 Chevy Volt Sparky shows no practical range loss after 400,000 miles. The Ontario-based car also still uses the first brake pads, thanks to the regenerative braking. Battery electric vehicles in all sorts will show unprecedented driving characteristics. But batteries are heavy and expensive. This sometimes calls for a smart compromise. From a user perspective, the battery size can be based on the personal or typical driving needs. Driving cycles are important to choose EVs on practical range and avoid batteries on wheels. A high range is flexible but expensive. A limited range can be enough to commute and is cheaper. Urban utility vehicles like buses and trucks can also be developed with dedicated charging. The newest electric city buses use en-route fast charging next to the overnight depot charging. The big business advantage of that utility vehicles with smaller batteries is that they can transport more. Although having smaller batteries, they still drive all day due to advanced fast charging strategies. To help energy management, trip monitoring is the most important control function of EVs. In fact, EVs are computers on wheels. All basic functions are electrified and digitized. In modern EVs, driving, charging, preheating, and predicted range can be monitored remotely. It goes without saying that low energy heating should be a standard equipment for EVs. Because of the high efficiency of the electric motor, there is little waste heat for interior heating. Individual heated seats, steering wheel and windshield, plus a heat pump can offer this. Very pleasant is that an electric heater is much faster than heating up an engine. Electrification leads to dramatic reduction of moving parts and maintenance. The moving parts count for a combustion car is typically 2,000. For an EV, it can be a few dozen. Apart from some auxiliaries, there is no need for maintenance and service accessibility. Functional updates, predictive maintenance, and crowd learning can be done over the air. The electrification of vehicles makes them very suitable for automated driving and sharing. All basic functions are electronically powered and in the well-controlled electronic domain. User mistakes can be easily ruled out by a smart control system and Internet of Things connectivity. And last but not least, open source EV technology will make sharing of innovation faster. If the market demands zero emission vehicles, the traditional OEMs may change fast. However, the change will still make victims under laggards and financial weak manufacturers. To conclude with, electric cars are an economic challenge for the whole automotive industry. Thank you very much.